All right, hello again. So, new update. So, yeah, fairly mild update, I think. I don't remember. I haven't been able to play as much. I forgot about this. Yeah, it's most definitely not free. I'm not the biggest fan. In order for you to get that for free, you have to purchase some cross crowns from the store. The Bounty Hunter event is back, so you can get pilots, and the pilots have been reworked. And I think there was a bit more that was done. I guess we'll go over the stuff that's here. Bug fixes. Improved the mechanics of the targeting acquisition of homing rockets. Now the targeting is reset correctly. Fixed a bug where a player could lose control of an armored car on hovers in combination with the Omnibox cabin. Improved the behavior of weapons from the AI controlled enemies. Now they aim correctly. Now after the destruction of the target, the weapon on the armored car doesn't turn around for a short time. Okay. Improved description of some modules. Now the module's name displays its type as well. Ooh, okay. So I'll take a look at that. Fixed a bug in the characteristics of the Aegis Prime and the Active Protection Oculus modules. Now the radius of their operation is specified correctly. The description of the Aegis Prime now displays the durability of the shield. Oh, nice. I would love to see that. Corrected certain elements of the Tower of Dawn map, where armored cars could get stuck. Okay, I think I can. Okay, that's good. Now player's power score is displayed correctly in post-battle statistics. Alright. Fixed a bug where the perk for the simulator could be changed by firing at allied armored vehicles. What? I'm sorry? If I had known that, I'd have been playing with that little bug. That would have been kind of cool to be able to shoot autocannon rounds whilst not being scoped in. That would have been interesting. Okay. And lastly, fixed a bug where after firing from the clarinet toe, the armored car turned around. I saw that one. I did not see that it was fixed because this is my first time playing since the update, but that's cool. Actually, no, I think I did play a couple matches after the update. I apologize for not uploading. I've been pretty busy, and I'm not actually sure how frequently I will be able to keep up with uploading. I'm also fairly certain that I may move on from uploading just cross-out content. I may start incorporating other content much more frequently because I'm looking to monetize my channel and that's not working out very well. Namely because I don't have a lot of subscribers, and that's pretty much the once I upload this video, that's the only thing I'm waiting on. So yeah. Alright, let's go back to the changes and updates. Other important changes. Implemented changes to the mechanics of combining movement parts. Ah, right, this particular change has some people upset. Can't say I didn't see that coming, and other people very happy. So now armored vehicles equipped with different types of movement parts will receive significant penalties to their maximum speed. The changes concern all types of movement parts except for combinations of tracks with wheels. Improve the perk activation button. Wait, what? Improve the perk activation button of the Amaterasu. Now it is activated by a separate button, not by the reload button. Okay. Now the field of the days module has a different color for enemies and allies. Improved a number of visual effects, in particular the effects of shells hitting the Aegis Prime and Nova shields. Now the effects of these shields are unique and more suitable for these modules. Improve the model of the Typhoon. Okay. I guess whilst we're on that, not market, exhibition, let me see if I can find a quick Typhoon build. And we can take a look at that. Alright, hold on. Exhibition. I think there's a Typhoon build in here. What? Okay, let's try playable. No, those are not. Ooh, this is a modified version of one of the packs. That works. Okay, well, I can show you how these work now. They are extremely slow with legs. Okay, ordinarily, we'll get to that later. There is a speed limit that's been implemented for combining multiple parts. Multiple movement parts. I'm sorry, that's not what I meant to tap on. I am not finding a tsunami build. Or a typhoon build, sorry, I always get the two confused. What is this? A house. Okay. Alright. Yeah, I'm not finding. Let me try likes and exhibition. That's a spark build, alright. I'm definitely testing this out. But not what I initially came here for. Bruh. Alright, well, anyways. I am not seeing any typhoons right now. I cannot see what they look like. Jasper looks cool though. That's a nice Leviathan. Alright, well, at some point I'll find those and cover them. But for now, what were the other things? Not this. Alright, so what was the other things? Clarinet toe, simulator, Tower of Dawn, Aegis. Ah, right. Let's go check out the health for the Aegis Prime. Alright, all the way back here. Aegis. The durability of the dome is 5,000 points. Okay. How come that is 5,000 points and this is 1,200? I am unsure at this point if this only absorbs damage for modules attached to this, or modules just attached to the vehicle, but whatever the case, yeah. Doesn't absorb a lot of damage. Versus this, which covers the whole vehicle and absorbs a lot of damage. Granted, that can reset. But, I don't know. I have some mail. Okay, well, I'll take this. Alright, back to the updates. Okay. Changes in balance of co-drivers. We have been closely monitoring statistics and your feedback and matchmaking and all that stuff that they normally say about the, about why they're making changes to, anything. Grizzly. Active skill cooldown is increased to 5 seconds. Reduce the activation distance of the passive skill, Thirst for Battle, from 60 to 50 meters. Reduce the damage boost from 15 to 10%. Wait, reduce the damage boost. That's one of his passive skills, isn't it? Can I please... Yes, there's more pilots. We'll get to them later. Ah, yeah, that would be the damage boost, I think. Cabin tonnage. Damage resist. Okay. Yeah, I only have a rare version of him, so... here. Alright. Billy. Or Biley. The passive skill improved gears, which increases the speed of the weapon's rotation, is now unlocked when the co-driver achieves a rare rarity. Replace the passive skill hidden explosives, which increases damage from self-destruct and explosion of the armored car, with the skill Starblaze Mechanism, which reduces the spread of miniguns, machine guns, and autocannons. The skill is unlocked when the co-driver achieves epic rarity. The passive skill Additional Charging Mechanisms, which increases the rate of fire of machine guns, miniguns, and autocannons, is now unlocked when the co-driver achieves relic rarity. Maximum bonus from the skill increased from 15 to 20%. Okay. Wait. So that means that... Okay. That's cool. That'll actually be pretty useful for miniguns, because even if you have a rare Billy, then he'll be boosting your rotation speed, and the miniguns have a slower rotation speed for some reason. Alright. Adelan, the passive skill, recharger mechanism, which increases reload speed of explosive weapons and flamethrowers, now increases the reload speed of shotguns. This skill is unlocked when the co-driver achieves relic rarity. The passive skill, movement parts armor, which increases the durability of movement parts, is now unlocked when this co-driver reaches epic rarity. The passive skill, Infernal Flames, which increases the heating rate of vehicle parts, is now unlocked when the co-driver reaches legendary. Replace the passive skill, Fireproof Armor, which increases the armored car's resistance to heating, with the skill Hidden Explosives, increases damage from self-destruct. This skill is unlocked when the co-driver reaches rarity? Wait, what? Recharger mechanism, which increases the reload speed, the first one I read, the one that increases reload speed of everything, that's relic rarity. Never mind. Hidden explosives is rare rarity. Okay. That's cool. Nice. Oh, speaking of which, she's the one I use for this build because it doesn't really have the durability for Grizzly to activate. Alright, so that's the balance changes to the co-drivers. Co-drivers. So, this message says that they're going to start the top part says they're starting the Bounty Hunter event on July 18th with a couple new co-drivers, Yuki and Falcon. Right, so Yuki is a pursuer, specializes in close combat and melee destruction. Her skill is activated when you attack an enemy from the rear. At the same time, she will recover or receive a temporary boost bonus to the damage and speed of the armored car. The surest solution is to hunt down and attack players who have strayed from their team. Sorry. Falcon is a versatile co-driver specializing in positional combat, can be effective with any type of weapon. His main perk increases outgoing damage, resistance, and cabin power, also reveals enemy positions. Jay specializes in snipers. Adeline, we just went over her. Close range shotgun pilot. Close range pilot. Because shotguns and melee weapons are the best close range weapons, but Theseus, as well as I think Theseus, Hyperion, and a few of the machine guns, especially Arbiters, are good for close range as well. Bailey specializes in machine guns and rapid fire weapons. Yeah. Grizzly, tank. Yes. Everything else hasn't really been changed much. I think they did say there was some. Hold on. So, Jay specializes in sniper weapons. Improves the game at long distances. Perk rewards precise shooting. Yes. Adelan, designed for close combat. Changes his perk for melee damage he deals, and when his perk is activated, makes parts vulnerable for a few seconds. Okay, not quite necessarily melee damage, but it does work with melee. And I'm unsure why he is a he, or labeled as that. Anyhow. Bit Bailey, machine guns, rapid fire weapons significantly increases rate of fire and weapon reloading when the perk is active. Grizzly, universal code driver of tank type. Changes his perk when receiving charges his perk when receiving damage. In addition, reduces damage to allies around him, receiving part of the damage instead of them. Yeah. All right. New battle pass season. Master of the Roads. Starting 26th, it's the 19th, so I am not going to, actually, I guess, sure, we'll look at the stuff. Battle Pass, dedicated to the Founders faction, you can expect ebony rewards in the season, including structural parts, blueprints for the legendary module Collapse, blueprints for the Epic Wheel Reach Stacker. Okay. Blueprints for the legendary Laser Destructor. Oh! That's the legendary version of the trigger. Okay. Blueprints for the Epic Nail Gun Argument. I've been calling the simulator a nail gun because it looks like one. But now an actual nail gun is going to be added into the game. Huh. That could be confusing. Unique armored car, laser cutter. Laser cutter. Okay, I'm going to assume the laser cutter will have some triggers because I highly doubt they're going to add a destructor into there. Onto it. But if they do, I won't complain. So. A module, a wheel, and two weapons. No cabin this time. There may be one in the leaderboard for the battle pass, but for now, there does not appear to be one. Yeah. New customization for profile, theme, new complete tasks and challenges, yeah. Battle Pass also includes a leaderboard where players complete according to their compete according to their Battle Pass leader Battle Pass level. Those who reach the maximum level by the end of the season will receive the most valuable rewards, including unique legendary nail gun power drill. Okay, so no cabin at all, just a epic and legendary nail gun, the legendary version of the trigger. A new wheel and the new module. I don't know what the new module does at this point, but we may find that out. Alright. Upcoming events. We would like to tell you about the events this week. We're all excited. Yeah. Oh, wait, hold on. Weekend. From July 21st to July 23rd, the daily limit of clan activity will be increased to 70,000. There will also be a 20% discount for opening clan containers. Okay, I will take that. Now hold on. I'm actually going to check the modules because one of my clanmates. Yep. The Collapser is in fact here. Let's see. Wait, that may mean the other weapons are here as well. Ooh, it's not very complicated to make. Alright. Upon activation, releases a powerful electromagnetic pulse which draws the enemy armored car towards the player. The radius of the pulse is 25 meters. Okay, so it's half of the Yokozuna's radius. Takes 9 seconds to cool down after activation. Pair this with the Yokozuna and you could yank someone to you and then throw them across the map. That could actually be kind of fun, especially on that map with pits. Huh. That's giving me ideas. Alright. Next is the wheel. Oh. This looks cool. This is like a double excavator tire. The outer part of the wheel has 1,000 durability. It cannot receive more than 250 damage per hit, and has a resistance to heating. Okay, so it's going to be between those and the arrays that you're going to be seeing around, I have the funny feeling. My jumbos should still shred these things, because the most they do per hit is 400 at this point. And that's for each piece of shrapnel. So, yeah. Four pieces of shrapnel will definitely hit that. So it should still be just as easy to take off one of those. Alright, no cabin, just weapons. I'm assuming the nail guns are going to be in here. Yes, they are. Wait. The lasers are going to be in the next one. Okay, so that's the simulator. Which is... Okay, the simulator is also a nail gun. Good to know. Alright. Argument. Okay. Not a bad crafting recipe. It is a 4-power weapon, so you can only fit 3 of them. The weapon receives additional charges for every 12 meters traveled. Once 8 additional charges have been received, you have the ability to fire an amplified shot. Okay. So my question is, how does this weapon fire? A nail gun that accumulates an amplified shot. Skillful driving and a fast armored vehicle will allow you to deal huge amounts of damage to enemies. It sounds like every 12 meters traveled. Wait. Wait, so if you've just got a very fast car and drive around for a while, once 8 charges are accumulated. Hold on. It doesn't say the charges are consumed. So if they're not consumed, I'm fairly certain they are consumed, because every 12 meters it accumulates a charge. That means you have to be driving around for... You don't have to drive for very long in order to accumulate 8 charges if it's every 12 meters. So... Or maybe you do. Okay, we'll see. I'll see when this weapon comes out. It actually sounds like it might be fun to use. Now for the power drill. This thing takes 3 points of 3 power, but it looks larger than the... Why does it look larger than the other one? A modified nail gun that fires flaming spikes deals a large amount of damage during prolonged fight with the enemy. Okay. This thing does thermal damage. What does this thing do? Bullet damage. Okay. Each spike that hits an enemy deals 12 damage every 0.5 seconds. The spike disappears after 3 seconds. The spikes gradually heat up and damage parts. Okay. This weapon actually sounds kind of fun, and you can fit 4 of them, because it takes 3 power. Yeah, this one might be pretty strong. Alright. The Destructor. Technologically advanced combat laser for medium to long range combat. What is the range on this thing then? Hold on, does the other one say that it's also for medium to long range combat? No, it says it's made for medium range combat. Okay, so this guy may very well have more range than the trigger. Medium to long range combat. Damaging to the precision and shooting skill. Or demanding. Demanding to the precision shooting skill. Has the ability to fire a powerful destructive shot. Okay, so I think what they were trying to say is it requires skill in precise shooting. Okay. Each destroyed part charges the perk by 25%. When the perk is charged, the weapon can fire a special amplified shot. The amplified shot has increased damage, heating effect, and impulse on hit. Structural parts receive increased damage. Heats up parts on hit. Fires without reloading. Charges before the shot. Okay, so this is basically the legendary trigger. Only it's got the additional perk to be able to fire a stronger shot. Wait, what does it take to craft this? Two triggers and an executioner. That could get expensive. Hold on, how much is the main expense for the executioner is the resources. Alright. Is that everything? I believe that's everything. Ooh, wait. Actually, I forgot we can look at the Typhoon in here. It actually doesn't look that bad. I believe that's everything. Alright. Well. That's the new update. Let's see what the changes to this look like. Okay, well, I'm not seeing any changes. It said these look different to teammates and enemies. I don't know. I don't see any differences. Well, anyways. Yeah. So, that is that. Oops. Wait, hold on a second. Hold on a second. Mark it. Let's go with wheel. I just want to check and see. Because it's possible that some of the new weapons have already been added. Mark it. They're going to be up here somewhere if they have. No. Not yet. Alright. No. Okay. None of the new stuff has been added to the market yet. Okay. Anyways, yeah. In addition to that news, I'm not sure how frequently I'm going to be able to upload to YouTube, and it won't be crossed out as consistently as it has been, because yeah, as I can tell, the English-speaking cross-out community is fairly small compared to others. And, yeah. Now, if I could speak Russian, I would probably just change language or use both languages in my videos when I'm playing cross-out, but I can't, because I know, since the game is Russian-based, the Russian community around this game is significantly larger. Or the Russian-speaking community, I should say. But, yeah, that's not an option. For me anyways, not right now. Anyhow. So, at this point for me, it's between Pixel Gun and Dead by Daylight Mobile, which both of them I have done videos are on. I used to do Dead by Daylight Mobile more regularly. But yeah, if any of you have suggestions for games you would like to see me try, feel free to let me know. I will be doing something on the, I will probably be doing something on the new War Thunder Mobile when it comes out, as me and some of my clanmates, or, well, yeah, still clanmates technically, are planning on playing that together. And just to let you know, my clan is disbanded. One of my clanmates decided to make their own clan, but my clan pretty much went dead. Not because people didn't want to play or anything, they just had life. And, unfortunately, for, the gameplay, a good chunk of them wound up suddenly having to, being busy, all at the same time, so that meant that we couldn't really do Clan Wars or anything anymore. So yeah. Peeps got tired and we were all like, alright, we'll just go our separate ways for the most part, but a few of them are still in this clan. A few of them moved to this clan. And a couple of my clanmates just wanted to get relic weapons, which we weren't really doing, because we could not stay in the top 100. So, yeah. They, left to go find clans that could do it. One of them made a clan of his own. I don't know. I think the other one is still looking. I don't know for sure. Or he may have found one. But, yeah. Anyways. Yeah, that didn't work. So yeah. Right. I forgot. No, not there. I forgot to actually show you all the new pilots. So, this is Yuki the Pursuer. She's the one who, gives you a bonus when you're attacking from behind. This skill charges when you deal damage to the rear of an enemy. He's an armored vehicle from a distance of at least 30 meters. In this case, the owner of the ability must also be behind the enemy's armored car. The rear part of an armored car is defined as a 90 degree angle of, or as an angle of 90 degrees from the middle of the vehicle. So 90 degrees, I believe that is like this. Okay, hold on. just for the sake of figuring this out, I believe that it would look like something. It would look something like, if I can find the panels for it. This. These aren't 90 degree slopes from what I understand, from what I remember, but something like that. Just pretend it's a bit more of a triangle. Actually, let me see. Oh, actually, I know. Maybe. Might do a better explanation. Oh my goodness. Sometimes the build menu is very annoying. Where's the other one? Okay. Anyways, yeah. I think something like that is defined as the back of the vehicle. So pretty much, I think, maybe the back corners of the vehicle and the full back of the vehicle. Pretty much the back corner of the vehicle, I think. If the vehicle was a full circle, the corner that's behind the cabin would, I believe, be what qualifies. No, not here, the other side. Pilots. Alright, so that's her. Oh, right, I have not gone over these. Turbocharge, cabin power 1%. I don't know how high that can go. Weapon cleaning, spread of shotguns and single shot shotguns minus 1%. Okay, that's not bad. Resistance of frames and wheels to any type of damage went plus 1%. Wait, what was this one called? Composite armor. Boarding. damage on the damage at a distance of less than 10 meters increased by 1%. Alright. Radar. Active range 1%. Alright. Falcon. Experienced mercenary is where he's called. Talented sniper. Raging shooter. Melee fighter. Reliable tank. Alright. So. This guy was kind of disappointed with, from the sound of his perk. The skill charges by 3% every 1 second. The fewer allies there are around, the faster the charging. The charged skill activates after you deal damage. The skill is active for 6 seconds. While the skill is active, armored vehicle is hidden from the radar. All enemies are displayed on the radar, and your car receives 5% to damage, 10% to cabin power, and 5% to resistance. Okay, so if you have a radar on this, active range is increased by 1%. Cabin power, 1%. Wait, what? Powerful sensors. Improved engine. Aggressive tactics, 1% to damage at speeds above 54 kilometers an hour. Ooh. Hold on a second. So this guy could be actually really good on some shotgun builds, or potentially even flamethrower builds. drive-by builds would be really good from this. If I remember correctly, turrets might work with him too. Weapon reloading speed increased by 1%. Reloading mechanism. Alright. So yeah, these are the two new co-drivers. Yeah, I think that's everything. So I will... Yeah, that's everything. So I'm gonna readjust this and hope you enjoyed, and I will talk to you later.